Oh, Miriam.
Yes, Paul.
Miriam, if Carlton is in his office, can you ask him a question for me? I need to know on what day of the week the Great Wall of China was finished.
Okay, just a second. Carlton is sure it was a Tuesday.
Thanks, Miriam. Carlton Tucker, what can I say? To some he is a conscience, to other he is a comfort, to others still he is a sage. And Carlton has been all of those things for me, but there's more. In the last 5 years, I have finished more New York Times crossword puzzles than I have in the 20 years beforehand. But don't take my word for it. There are others at Princeton Day School who would like to tell you what Carlton has meant to them. So enjoy this short film.
We've had our pizza, we got one more spot. We're gonna fill this class, this retiring class of 2013. We need one more spot. These are all really, really compelling. I don't know how we can choose, but you know, there is one file here that we haven't talked about, so maybe we should just hear this file once. Okay, let's see. We have a male here. He'll have been at PDS for 20 years. Mm-hmm. Two children here, and he advised and shepherded more than 2,000 graduates out of the upper school. He created the Life for Dinner, the Baccalaureate Dinner, the lecture series that we have. So statistically, he has attended more games, performances, and assemblies than the whole faculty put together. And that includes hanging out at post-prom, sometimes till 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning.
He loves that.
He brought Chinese to PDS. He's famous for bringing us the Halloween parade, never disappointing in his costumes. And he remembers exactly how many snow days we've had every year going back 20 years. I don't know, what do you guys think?
I think he's the one.
Yeah, he's the one too.
Hands down.
All right, it's decided. Carlton Tucker, retiree class of 2013.
Compassionate, accomplished, respected, loyal friend, trustworthy.
Oh, optimistic.
Nice, thoughtful, unflappable.
Caring,
kind-hearted,
extraordinary.
Reliable.
We'll miss you!
Here's our list of the top 10 reasons we will miss Carlton Tucker.
We will miss hearing your familiar jokes year after year. Yes, that is a lot of tuition.
We will miss hearing the instructions that none of us could follow on how to march in and out at graduation.
We will miss the opportunity to hear the word pithy used regularly in a sentence.
We will miss watching you squeeze into the student desks in our classrooms.
3 factorial. We will miss the look on your face whenever you are singled out for an accomplishment, like right now.
We will miss your larger-than-life Halloween costumes.
We will miss your insightful comments after observing our classes and the look on your face when witnessing a particularly complex lesson.
We will miss seeing you tower over us as you warmly greet us each morning.
We will miss your affection for your children demonstrated by Michael's preschool painting proudly displayed on your office door.
7 to the 0 power. We will miss your respect, support, guidance, leadership, and responsiveness.
We'll miss you, Carlton!
We're going to look forward for you, and there are a few things we're looking forward to having you enjoy in this next step. One of them is, I think I'm looking forward to your finally being able to read the Chronicle for Higher Education cover to cover and not have me run by your office every 5 seconds with questions, and also me not challenging you in the hallway anymore for the loudest voice in the administrative wing.
I look forward to reading about how you fulfilled your final 2 years of eligibility playing basketball at Williams College, our alma mater. I know that you only played JV for 2 years in Williamstown, so I hope that you've been playing, you know, practicing your low post moves and finally making varsity.
And we all look forward to seeing plenty of you in the college office as you work with your kids through the process.
We'll miss you!
Who can, by stillness, little by little, make what is troubled grow clear?
Who can, by movement, little by little, make what is still grow quick?
These lines are from Ursula Le Guin's translation of the Tao Te Ching, and here is her version of chapter 27, which she entitles Skill.
Good walkers leave no track.
Good talkers do not stammer.
Good counters don't use their fingers.
The best doors unlocked and unopened.
The best knots not in a rope and can't be untied.
So wise souls are good at caring for people. They never turn their back on anyone.
They're good at looking after things, never turning their back on anything.
There's a light hidden here.
There's a light hidden here.
Good people teach people who aren't good yet.
The less good are the makings of the good.
Anyone who doesn't respect a teacher or cherish a student may be clever, but has gone astray.
There's a deep mystery here.
There's a deep mystery here.
Who can, by stillness, little by little, make what is troubled grow clear?
Carlton, the foreign language department decided that anyone who was in charge for 20 years of so many wacky, if lovable, upper school teachers deserves to be called a saint. And so we're going to canonize you in our own way. We're going to sing When the Saints Go Marching In, first in English, and then in the four languages you helped to promote: Chinese, French, Spanish, and Latin. So here we go.
Our last bits of old business here. Rome Campbell cannot play the Commodores as pregame music. And Scott Bertoli has volunteered his newborn son to be the Panther for life once he can walk.
And hair gel will not be outlawed as part of the dress code.
Okay.
So,
as a bit of new business, I don't know whether you've heard, but Carlton Tucker is retiring. And as you may know, he does a lot of things here at the school and is going to leave a big gap in leadership.
So if Carlton is going to retire, then we need to unretire. We need to come out of retirement.
Yeah, I'm down. Let's do this.
Good idea.
Out of retirement? Let's do this!
Do what?
Carlton, thanks for all your support throughout the years. Even with all of us coming out of retirement, we could never hope to replace you.
Ready, Carlton on three. One, two, three, go!
Someone once told me at an assembly a long time ago that the Chinese character for crisis has actually two compositions. One represents danger, but the other represents opportunity. Losing you as our leader represents a crisis for us. We've come to depend on your fairness, your integrity, and your vision. But it also represents, for our department, an opportunity to look back on these last 20 years.
Hi, Carlton. Welcome to Choate Rosemary Hall, where you began your career. This is Alex Curtis, thanking you for all that you've done at Princeton Day School.
I wanted to say thank you for giving me my first teaching job way back in 1996.
Speaking of reigns, Carlton, it might interest you to know that if you were a Roman emperor, you would have been the fifth longest lasting emperor in the entire 500-year history of the Roman Empire. Pretty impressive feat, I think.
We thank you for all the wonderful times we shared here together at PDS.
Thank you for the years of inspiration, both at PDS and beyond.
Thank you for all of the support you gave me during my, not only during my years at Princeton Day School, but after I left also.
Congratulations on a fantastic career and for 6 great years of mentorship.
Thank you, Carlton. We'll miss you.
I'm going to have to call you back. I don't know what's going on.
People are freaking out.
Nina, I need you to come over here. I can't get her to stop crying.
They won't leave my office.
I'm so stressed.
Carlton is leaving.
Oh, my heart's hurting so bad.
You better put an ad in the Princeton packet.
Wait a second. Oh, Captain, my Captain.
Oh, Captain, my Captain. Captain, my Captain.
Captain, my Captain.
Oh, Captain, my Captain. Oh, Captain, my Captain. Oh, Captain, my Captain.
On behalf of Student Services, Carl, we're gonna miss you. Thanks for everything.
To thank you for your support and guidance over our years of working together. You know, it occurred to me, I am sure the members of the department would like to thank you themselves, so let's take a walk through the area and see who we can find.
I know those dedicated professionals are busy in their corners, hard at work.
Come on, man, I'm raising you 3 reeds. Come on.
I'll see those reeds. I'll raise you 1, 2, but not 3.
The amount of work they're doing around here is dizzying.
Come on, faster!
Come on, is that all you got?
You've introduced us to new methods of conflict resolution. You've inspired us to develop new skills and interests and let the sparks fly where they may. And you've encouraged us to grow and develop in ways that are even beyond our own wildest imaginings.
The science department has had a long working relationship with you, Carlton. From the moment you arrived, we worked together on curricular reform. Remember the scientific method? Your support and investment in the sciences has helped us to change the time we had to teach science. Yes, in fact, you were indeed one of the originators of what has come to be known as the science block. On top of all this, your stamp of approval helped to move the science room renovations along. These are just a few of the milestones that we achieved through our partnership. As you know, you are an honorary member of our department. Thank you for all of your support, but mostly thank you for listening.
But all I need is one friend to get me through the day. One friend who never goes away. Only one friend to understand and never let. Well, I've been in love, and I've been in